my brother, and I'm talking to this brother about some stuff happening in his life. We're doing a series on being responsible when you drink. So before you get into your story, tell me just your views about being responsible while you're drinking.
Well, I feel like if you're drinking and you're under the influence, you should only hop on, you should hop on a bike and pedal. You shouldn't have an engine underneath you. Never operate an engine or anything mechanic or machines when you're drinking or you're under the influence. You could chop your hand off, you could lose your arm, you could wake up missing something, an eyeball or something. Operating machines under the influence of anything. So you should never operate a machine or anything robotic under the influence. When you wake up in the morning, you got a clear head. That's the best time to operate. If you start drinking, a buzz driver is a drunk driver. Okay. It's no difference. Make sure you have your license and your insurance. Do not be riding down the street and catch a vehicular homicide, be sitting in jail for 20 years because you didn't have your license and insurance right. You couldn't stop after you hit someone's child, dog, cat, kitten, squirrel. Don't kill nothing. Don't let nothing die.
So what's your situation? You said that
My situation, a person was coming through 49th Street. He didn't know that the turn was a total U-turn. So he came down at a certain speed. And when he turned and banked the car, he didn't know that he had to keep on turning. The car went up on two wheels. The car flipped. Now, he was being chased by some people, some bad people from the neighborhood. He hopped out the car and ran to the store. He was bleeding. He was like, yo, somebody was chasing me. I just flipped my car over. I said, I'm a mechanic. I'm going to go back and see what I could do. He said, you can't do nothing. The car flipped over. I said, I'm a mechanic. Even if the car flipped over, I probably could flip it back and see what it's worth. He said, man, if you go back, the keys is in the car. It's yours. I went back to the car, removed the keys out the car. A rookie officer walked up and said, hold on, put your hands behind your back. What are you doing by that car? I said, I'm just getting the keys out of here. I'm a mechanic from the neighborhood. It's the day before Father's Day. I've been drinking, and I'm trying to help a friend out. He went to go get medical attention. He didn't want to get medical attention right here because the people who was chasing him were still behind him in the neighborhood. So I went back and retrieved the keys for him. The rookie cop said, stand over there. Then he said, sit in the car. He put me in the car. Two Caucasian officers pulled up. They didn't ask no questions. They put handcuffs on me, took me to jail. You got the keys to the car you was driving. They never waited for the story. I'm here today on the 23rd fighting this case. I live in Mesa, Arizona. I'm not even supposed to be in Philadelphia anymore. I'm back in Philadelphia dodging bullets. My mom's house been shot up since I've been here. I can't come back to Philadelphia. Because Fresh Prince can't come back from fucking Bel Air neither. Sorry. The hood won't accept them anymore. There's no Hollywood in the hood. I'm so sorry, sir. Have a nice day. I got a court date to be at.
Thank you, my brother. Appreciate you.
Appreciate you too, sir.
Good luck. I'll be praying for you, Reverend
Thank
Evans.
You. I hope everything goes well.
Absolutely. Thank you very much. Thank you, man. Appreciate that.
Story